Zod is a TypeScript-first schema declaration and validation library. It allows you to declare a validator once and remove all of the repetitive types you may have in an application. What's great about Zod is that you don't need to use it in a TypeScript app. So if you have a JavaScript app, you can also use Zod. Zod can be used with pretty much any front-end library or even in your backend. So it makes it easy to reuse the schema and make sure that your user input is valid regardless of how it's entered. I've talked a little bit about Zod here, but let's go and see it in a real-world application. I have a form that I've created that currently takes some user inputs. But the struggle of user input is anyone could put something in a form and it wouldn't be validated until you either write regex, which is always complex, or you try and validate it based upon some sort of typing. So let's look at that. So here we have the form. It has a full name, which is supposed to be first and last name. It has a email, has a subject, which is any of these selections here. We have a budget, and then we have a message. And when we hit submit, in theory, this would go out to an API, and then that API would then pass the information to wherever we want it to be. So if I hit submit here, you can see in the console, there's an object, and inside that object is a bunch of different stuff. And each one is based upon what's here. But as you can see from this code, we have a handle submit up here that just takes the form data, pulls all the values out based upon the object, and then console logs them out. Now, in theory, you would be sending this to an API or maybe to your backend or doing something with it. But just for this simplicity, we're going to be showing you how to validate this schema and then use it in general. So let's talk about how Zod works. So you install Zod by using npm install Zod, and then you can create a schema and use that schema to show what kind of types each of these input fields should be. So we know for a fact a name should be a string. An email should be a string, but it should be the type of email. So we should be receiving an email. And if we don't receive an email, we should be able to throw an error message. The subject, it should be only one of these three options. Now, just imagine if someone has managed to, say, modify some HTML, add an additional option that wasn't part of this schema. And I'm talking about bad actors here more than just a regular user. And let's say they add an additional one. So at that point, the form would be invalid, right? So if it's not one of these three, it would be invalid. Finally, we have a budget here. We know it's going to be a string, but we want them to be able to type in however much their number is. And then finally, this message here, it should be long, right? So a message should be more than, say, a few characters. But right now, we don't have that restriction. So the user could type in whatever they wanted to. And I don't really want to write a bunch of JavaScript to make that happen. So now we can start using Zod. So we've created this examples folder so I can show you how it works before we go back to our form here and then create our own schema. So the way that Zod works is you import Z from Zod. And then we get to use Zod to create these kinds of schemas. So we could say const, let's say full name equals Z dot. And then we give it a type that we expect it to be. So we expect this to be a string. And now we've created the schema, we can validate against it. So we can pass in things to it and get a result. So we can do something like const first name equals James. And we know that's a string. And then we could do second name and we can make this a number. And then the way that we validate against this full name is we do full name dot parse, and then we pass in whatever we want. So we can just do first name. And for this, we would get a good result. And then if we did the second name, we'd get a bad result because obviously it should be a string, but this is a number. So that's basically how it works. And it gets more complex, right? So we can do a schema object equals z dot object. And then inside of our object, we can then set a bunch of different strings. So we could say z dot user is z dot string. And then our next one could be email is also a z dot string. But we could have age is z dot number. And then we could use this to pass in an object and verify whether or not that is true. So that kind of gives you a very basic rundown, but let's talk about how we can validate this schema that we have right now in this form. So what's good about Zod is it can be used on both the client side and in your APIs. So you can write a schema one time, validate it on both client and server side using the same schema. So what I'll do here is I'll create a new folder and we'll call it Zod schema. It's not a very good naming convention, but I'm going to create a file in here called schema. And we'll say schema.js. Obviously, if you're using TypeScript, you can use TypeScript, but it's not a requirement. So I'm just going to use JavaScript to keep the example as basic as possible. So again, we import Z from Zod. We'll call it form schema. I'm going to say Z.object. And then inside of our object is where everything is going to be. So now we need to look at our form here again and say, is each one of these is an individual. So first name and last name are both individualized. So we can put those in. So we can do first name should be a z.string. Last name should be z.string. And then we have email. And what we can actually do here is we can tell Zod we expect it to be a string and an email. So you can do that by doing z.string.email. And it will validate that against an email address. So it will say, hey, is this valid or not? And you don't have to write the regex that comes along with it. You can just use z.string.email and it will say, hey, this is not an email. Let me throw an error message. Then we have our subject here. And what we can do here is do an actual enum here and tell it that we expect it to be these three values. And if it's not one of these three values, throw an error message. So we can do subject. It'll be z.enum, and that tells us that we're going to expect some sort of 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5, however many variables, and it has to be one of these. Then you do an array, and then you set the array to the things that we want it to be. So we know that each one of these values right here is either going to be advertise, partnership, or general questions. So we can pass those in. Say advertise, partnership, or general question. We'll just copy and paste these to be quicker than me typing them out. So now we have that, it has to be one of those. And then the final part is our message, which is this section right here. So we can say message, and we can say z.string. And we can go one step further here and we can actually set the length. So to do that, you can just do dot min and then we set it to whatever number we think the minimum amount should be. So let's set this to 10 and hit save. And now we have a minimum length of 10 characters for our messages. So now we have that. Let's go ahead and use this. So at the top, we can import this. So import form schema from Zod. Schema, now we have access to it. So now we can actually use this wherever we want. So now we're ready to use our form schema here. So we can do const results equals and then form schema. So that's what we use dot. And we're going to use safe pass here because we don't actually want it to throw an error message. We can handle the error ourselves. So you can do that by doing safe pass and then pass in our value here. And then we have access to this. And then we can just log out our result here. So console log results, and we can see what's inside of it. So let's go back to our application and hit submit. And this is a form that has all the correct information in it. So it should be fine. And as you can see here, what we get is the success is set to true. And then underneath that, we have everything that was inside of there. So now we can say if results.success, and we'll set this to if it's false. And we can say if this success is not true, we can console log results. So I can show you what happens when there's an error message. So the easiest way to do this would be just delete out something in here and say sub. And as you can see here, we got this Zod error message here that says validation email code invalid string. And then there's a longer message here. And we can see that it says invalid email, and it gives you all sorts of things here inside of here, but basically the part that we need is it's an invalid email. Again, if we change this mid length to just hellos and hit submit, you'll get that this is an invalid email, but let's fix the email and then hit submit. And now we get this one. It says code, it's too small, minimum is 10, type string. So at that point in here, you could set some sort of boundary that says if there's a result, just hit return and don't continue on. Otherwise, yes, it's successful. Go ahead and do that. You can also do the exact same thing in the schema. You can use it in here in the API route. So you can just import form schema and then wherever your util might be. So for us, it's ./... and then /schema. And then you can use this the same way you could pass in something, const results equals, and then form schema.safePass. And then we could do request.body, for example, and then do the exact same thing and send a result back the same way. So now we can use this in the back end as well as the front end. So there you have it, a very short introduction into the complex world of Zod. If you are interested in learning more about Zod, click the link in the description. I'm going to send you off to a more in-depth tutorial that goes through all sorts of things with Zod. It's not run by me, but it is run by someone in the community who does really good stuff with TypeScript.